One last type of linked entry is a link to an operating system command or some kind of a file that is associated with a different application. For example, a spreadsheet or a Word document. So let's go ahead and add that. First, I'm going to deselect what I'm currently selected by. I can click in between the new and the open button. It's kind of a handy place to deselect, to click and deselect. As I want this to be a level 2 and I want it to appear at the bottom of the list, I'm going to go ahead and do File, New, and I'm going to do a link to an operating system command. So it's a process book entry, and the link is now going to be to this OS command that we see right here. Now in this case, I'm going to choose Windows Calculator, and I'll just say something like 2 Calculator. And there's a couple ways you can do it. If this is one of the something that's available from within Windows from the command prompt, you can just type the name of the executable, and that'll work just fine. I'll go ahead and put this at a level 2. As you can see, it will go ahead and execute that properly. But you can't always count on that. Not all executables are going to be available from everywhere within Windows. So typically what you would do is you would go out and let me edit this again. You would go out and for this linked operating system command, you would browse to the application. So I'll choose Browse Applications. And in the case of this Windows Calculator, it's going to be under Windows System 32, and it's called calc.exe. I missed it. Here we go. Now there are some applications for which you're going to have to specify the working folder. Basically, the working folder is going to be ignored if you're launching any of the applications that ProcessBook is familiar with. That's most of the Office applications and the standard Windows applications. But if you've got some application that requires a working folder to be associated with the executable, then you go ahead and put that, just browse for that working folder here. So in this case, we're not going to do that. And when we go ahead and execute this, this works just fine. And there we go. Now let's go ahead and do the same thing, this time for a link to a different type of a file, one of the data files associated with an Office application, for example. First, I'll go ahead and deselect this, just click in between there. Let's do File, New. This is going to be a link to an operating system command. We'll make sure this is a level 2. And in this case, let's go to a shift report. This is going to be a shift report that's already been pre-configured in Office, in Excel specifically. I'll go for all files here, and I'm going to go out and look where I've got that particular file stored. Yeah, here's a simple report. This is an XLS file. Now I'll go ahead and acknowledge, and this should go ahead and initiate the retrieval. And here's our resulting spreadsheet. Now in many cases you're probably going to be putting links to websites, and that's no problem. Let me go ahead and save this, by the way, now that I've created all my links. And you'll find examples of that in the pydemo.piw. You'll see if you go to this OSI section, here are links to the different web pages that we maintain. Here's our tech support web page, for example. And if we take a look at these in build mode, you'll see that all we've done is we've simply specified the URL in that action. Here's one last thing to mention about creating these types of links. Sometimes when you create a link to something like, for example, a Word document, you'll get a behavior that we're tracking down to file associations in ProcessBook. Let me demonstrate. I'm going to go out and find a file that is a Word document. I'll go out into, let's just go where our interface documentation is stored. Program files, PyPC, interfaces. And we want to look at the PyPerfmon basic interface document. Now, by default, you'll see this ignored default shell command for recognized file types, which means that if you're associating this ProcessBook link with a file type that's already known to ProcessBook, then it will go ahead and launch it in ProcessBook instead of launching it in the other application. And you'll see what happens with this. Normally we would only do this for those things that are that ProcessBook knows about. And as you can see, ProcessBook is, it thinks it knows how to render this, but it doesn't. And this is something that we're tracking down to. It's probably the work of an add-in, something we should address. But for right now, there's an easy workaround. If you just disable that button, this ignore, or just uncheck this checkbox, so that we'll no longer ignore the shell command. Then when you double-click on this, it will launch the appropriate command. Now, so right now, we're categorizing this as kind of an, you know, an unfortunate artifact of the design, in which some of our, as you can see, some of the things that we support through either OLE automation or through add-ins, they end up, in the case of Word documents, they end up, we try to open that up here, which is the correct behavior for most things, but not for that. So we'll go ahead and disable that, or tell it to not to ignore the Word document application, and that should go ahead and open it up in Word. So the takeaway here is that if you're trying to implement one of these links, and you're using a document type that for whatever reason is being recognized by ProcessBook when this default is selected and it attempts to launch it itself, the takeaway is just go in and clear this, and that should give you the better behavior that you were looking for originally. Of course, if you run into problems, please give us a call on tech support.